Hello YouTube. Okay, so I'm going to do a little video on my bag here. It's kind of like a day pack, well, not really a day pack, maybe a overnight or bug out bag, whatever you want to call it. But there's generally enough in here that I could stay out for a night or two with what food's in it, and after that you'd have to sort of be hunting or whatever. But anyway, let's get into it. It's the bag itself is called a Caribee, I think it's Day Ops backpack, and it's a 50 litre pack. I'll put a picture of it, and the price, current price, is $139 from BCF. So it's a fairly large bag, but I haven't packed it out like to its as much as you could fit in it. You could fit a lot more in it, but I wanted to keep it light. By memory, I think it's around 10 kilos. As far as like hiking bags go, hiking bags are much lighter, but this is a much more durable kind of bag. So anyway, let's have a look at it. At the front here, it has this little kind of, it's like a semi-attached pouch. So inside that pouch, I carry a map or two. Well, it depends on where I'm going to be sort of heading. So I have a topo map in there. I think there's a small plastic bag in there as well, just down at the bottom. On top, a little paracord bracelet. Nothing special there, you've all seen one of those. So inside the front pouch, it's a fairly large pouch. That's what I like about this bag, you can really open it up to get into it. So right down the bottom here, I've got just some gloves, inner glove. There's some AAA batteries. Now they supply my headlamp, which I'll show you that. Three sticks of face camouflage. Now these little pouches down here, there's not really much in there. It's this little paper here. I don't even know what that is. Oh, okay, that's the instructions to the speedy stitcher sew all. I normally have that in the bag, but I had to use it for something, so it's not here at the moment. So I have to put that back in. Let's put that there for now. So there's also just a small light. This one's a AA. Powered light. I think I bought it from probably, maybe it was BCF or super cheap. It's a fairly cheap light, but really it's only for an emergency. My other lights I carry are a bit better. So yeah, this is all just purely emergency stuff. So also there with the light, as you can see, I've got four Artline markers. So the different colours, depending on who you're with or whatever, you could use a different colour to write a note, or even just make a marking somewhere. People might, whoever you're with, they'd know what you're using the colour for, what it means, etc. So yeah, there's four of them. Down in this pouch, there's a couple of P2, I think they are, three P2 face masks. The UV pack light, these work on UV light and then they glow. So you could light that up with your torch and then you've got a bit of light that'll last for a little while. They don't last for a hell of a long time, but You know, they're okay. AA batteries, so that goes with this other torch here. That's all that bit now. A little zipper in here. Now down in there, got one cable tie. Also got this plastic disposable drop sheet. That's from Bunnings. I think they're about either 99 cents or $1.99. Pretty cheap. And you know, you can do a lot of stuff with these. Whatever you have to do. Ziploc bag. I think is there two? No, just one. It's kind of large Ziploc bag. So you could keep food in that after you've eaten. What else is down here? Another Ziploc bag with a couple of elastic bands in it. Another cable tie. And that's it for that pouch. Ooh, 6 minutes already. This is taking longer than I thought, but anyway. So the top pouch here, got some Hydrolite. Always good to have. So got a little Ziploc bag there with medications. So you can tailor that to whatever you need, whatever medication you think you might need for a little while. So mostly there's pain relief in there. There's some cold and flu tablets, antihistamines, and just stuff that I might need. Got a small packet of earplugs. This is one of those magic little towels that you just wet and then it sort of expands out. Don't know how you explain it, but it becomes a hand towel. So you can wet that with hot water or cold water, whatever you want. Winter here in Australia, but it's pretty mild, 20 degrees. So that's the first pouch, compartment, whatever. Let's go into a side one. So this is the left side. In here, I've got my water purification stuff. So, got some water purification tablets. Expires in 2023. Okay. So yeah, got those. We have a Milbank bag. Looks brand new, like I've never used it. I've used it a couple of times, but just to see how it works. But yeah, it works. It's from the UK. Bought it on eBay. You'll find them there somewhere. So I think this was the Sawyer squeeze kit. So you get this, you get the filter, the main filter part here. This end here will screw onto this part of your bag. So the way it works is you fill that with water. You probably like in a dam or a creek or however you're going to get the water. And this is 64 ounces, which works out to be about 1.8 litres. So I've got two of those, that 1.8 litre. This smaller one is a 32 ounce, which is about 900 mils. So I have used this and works perfectly. Basically just shoved it under water, filled it up with the water, stuck the filter on top, and then on the top part, doing this one-handed, but you just pull the lid and it's like a normal bloody drinking from a bottle. Speaking of which, pretty sure this thread here will fit your normal sort of standard plastic bottle. So if you put water in a plastic bottle, you could stick this on top and then drink through it. You got your filtered water. That kit came with a few other attachments. That would be another video, I guess, for the future. But basically you can drain water out of a bucket and filter it through that filter. So yeah, that's definitely another video. Okay, moving on to the other side pouch. So there's a pouch on each side, obviously. You could put a drink bottle in those pouches too. You do whatever you want to put in there. This side, well, it's a little bit messy, but this side is for my fire lighting kind of equipment stuff. There's also a knife. This knife lives in the bag, and it's a little Chinese copy of a nice little Browning knife, but it's quite good. The etching and whatnot is on it is pretty good. But that guy lives in this bag. I'm gonna light my fire. Fire striker. Further down in here, I've got a Falcon Niven DC4 sharpening stone. I'll try and grab it out. There we go. So it's got like the diamond edge, diamond sort of impregnated side, and then standard side on here. There's lots of reviews on the DC4 on eBay, YouTube, so you can look further into that. What else we got in here? Got some stormproof matches in a little kit there. It's got some cotton in the top there to use for tinder, little striker on the side. This little guy, you've probably seen these around, I think it's called the pocket shot. There's a cheap Chinese version of it. Carry a few little pebbles and stuff in there. So it's like a glove gun, really. It doesn't really shoot the pebbles very far. You could use that to make a noise. You couldn't use it to take out any game. It's just not powerful enough, but that lives in there. Got a little fire lighter there as well. Normally have two of them. Bic lighter. Always got to have a Bic lighter. Have a few of those. This is a little smoke signaling thing. Found that on Wish. Got two of those. Never tried it. Should try it one day. But you light it and it gives off smoke. They're advertised as to use them for photography, for special effects. But I threw them in there. And I think that's all for that side. So we'll be diving into the main pouch now. Right, just before I go into the main pouch, I forgot this little guy up here. So in this little pouch up the top, it's where I keep my headlamp. I'll normally put a pair of gloves in there as well, maybe. But there's just a headlamp in there at the moment. As for the batteries, I keep batteries in there, but I turn one backwards and seems to stop them from leaking. So the battery is always in there, but just turn backwards, ready to go. There's a small little pouch here. Oh, I've got something in here. What have I got in here? Okay, got a micro USB cord. It's probably a bit defunct now because using a later model phone which has the C-type adapter, but so we might take that out, can use that somewhere else. A little packet of tallyhos. I don't smoke, but you could use that paper for lighting a fire, or if you come across someone that has tobacco and they got no papers, well, they're in luck. Okay, so I've got two fox whistles. Yeah, these are, I think these are from eBay as well, and they do work. I have whistled foxes in. It's quite funny. You get them to come up so close. So there's two different noises. This one. You got that one, and then this other one. Let's see if I can blow it. Haven't used it for a while. No, sorry, can't do it. Anyway, they're in there. Okay, now we can dig into the main pouch. So you got little buckles on the side here that help hold this outer pouch. So when you unbuckle those buckles there, you got a lot more space to carry something in there. So you could put, I suppose, your jumper or whatever you can think of. Let's open the main pouch. Okay. So in here we've got a liter of water down the bottom here. It's a clean canteen. What have we got there? 1.1 liters it would be, 40 ounces. And it is very clean, as you can see. It doesn't get used much at all. So I'll give it a clean out now and then, but yeah, you could put that over the fire and boil. It's only downside, it has a plastic lid. It is one of the Pathfinder things. I don't have the cup for it to put on a fire, but that's another video, because that's a part of this bag that becomes a kit. And I don't have that here today, I've just got the bag. So anyway, that's 1 liter of water there. Sorry, I've got to keep pausing because I've got planes flying over, ignorant, noisy people in their cars while I'm trying to do a video. So here we have the Cedar Summit Thermolite Reactor Plus. So this guy, I think, gave you up to 10 degrees of extra warmth when you're in a sleeping bag. Now, in this kit, this is really the only thing I've got to give you warmth, except for the bivy here, and there's a tarp here. And the reason behind that is I figure you'll build a fire, but actually sleeping in this thing and the bivy is quite warm. And like I said at the start, I'm trying to keep this pack light, so that's why I don't carry a sleeping bag in here. So we've got that guy. This is the Soul Escape bivy. There's two versions of these bivvies. There's that fluoro orange one, and then there's this one. And I'm not going to open it up, I've got one hand only, but basically you can zip yourself completely up in this, and on the inside it has like a this silvery fabric to trap your body heat. So like I said, if you're wearing that, this the reactor inside of this, you're going to keep quite warm. And here in Australia, I mean, in winter it's a bit colder, but we'd use a fire. In summertime, you'd probably only sleep in this bivy just to keep the bugs away from you. Yeah, that's in there. On this side is a hoochie, or a tarp. Can't remember the dimensions offhand, but bought this at Anaconda for, I think it was like $17. You can buy them, the original ones, the original Australian military ones. They'll set you back closer to $100. But this is waterproof and does the job. There's some paracord in there. I think, by memory, I've got enough paracord in there to string it up so you could make a shelter from it. You could also wrap yourself in it inside the bivvy and the reactor, just depending on how you needed to sleep for that time, wherever you are. So it fits there. In the center, we've got a 24-hour ration pack by Hunger Buster. This one is beef. I don't know what this one is. What is it? This one's a chicken Italiano. So there's a few different menus you can choose from. Purchased this from the Aussie Storm Shop. So that's the main food that I'm carrying in here. The top here, we've got a shemagh. You all know what you can do with that. Also carry a merino wool jumper. So if even in summer, I still carry it. If you were to get wet, or it's just suddenly turns crazy cold, always got that ready to go. Now, underneath this stuff, there's not really anything apart from this little pouch here. So in this little pouch, we've got some beef jerky, teriyaki beef jerky. That's good to munch on. I have this Tyvek sheet, which it's made by DuPont. Bought this on eBay from America. So it's what they use in construction for sealing your house, like when they're building a house. This stuff is, it's papery, like it's like paper, but it is completely waterproof. When you first get it, it is very loud and crinkly. There's a technique where you can turn it into this like more softer sounding. And yeah, it's very stiff too when you get it, when you first get it. But that can be used as a ground sheet, or you could use that to cover yourself if it's raining, because it's completely waterproof. And I've used it over a swag to keep me dry, to keep the swag dry on a pissing down camping trip. And so also down in here, there's a plastic bag. There's some luxury items here. Hand warmers. There's another one. So I've got 4 packets of hand warmers. That's a very, very luxurious item. Yeah, they work quite well. There's a big hunk of paracord hidden down the bottom there. That's it, there's nothing else in there. Now you see this Velcro down into there. You can put a water bladder down in the back there. So I don't have a water bladder in it, but maybe I might try and get it, just a small one, maybe a 1 liter bladder. And it pokes out through the top there. So your drinking tube goes out through the top of the bag. I do have a Camelback. It's a 3 liter water bladder. Really, you could strap that to the outside of this bag if you wanted to, but I might try and fit a small water bladder into there. Not sure, see how we go. All right, let me just tidy this up and I'll show you what it looks like at the back. So this is the probably the business end, really, because you've got to carry the bag. So it has a little bit of a padding here. It's probably like, I don't know, when you put your weight against it, it compresses quite a lot. So it's vented, and yeah, my back sweats when I'm carrying it. There's not much you can do about it. Just make sure you drink some water. So it has at the top of the bag, it's got some adjustment there, so you can pull in the strap, whatever makes it feel comfortable for you. Just here is where your water bladder drinking tube would come out. Then you'd run that down to, has a little clip there for your hose. Slide that up and down wherever you want. You got your sternum strap, and then your strap here to adjust it, and then your kidney belt part, whatever you call it. It's held in there with Velcro, so you can take that off if you don't want it, but carrying a backpack with a bit of weight for a long time, you definitely want this because it takes a lot of load off you. There's probably some things missing from this bag, and there could be too much in there. So it just depends on what you like to carry, where you are, what the climate's like, what your mission is, what your goal is. But yeah, you can definitely add to it. It's got plenty of molly on the front here. It's got molly on the sides. One thing I realized I didn't have in here is a pair of gloves. So these are my go-to gloves, the Mechanics Original. I really like these because nice fit around your hand. Velcro there, it's got a Velcro closure there. And you can still feel a lot with them. You can still do a lot of tasks with them. I think that actually the reason I don't carry them in the bag is because I'm normally wearing gloves. But I should throw a pair in because once they get wet, they take a little while to dry. And if it's cold, your hands freeze. So you need to kind of rotate the gloves around. So I generally have several pairs of gloves with me. Just for that fact, but yeah, that's it. That's my bug out overnight bag, whatever you want to call it. That's it. That's the bits that are in it. And if you want to know any more about those little bits, leave a comment. But otherwise, that is it. I hope you have a good day. And stay safe.